Hello students, today we are going to study the channel capacity by Shannon's Hartley and its proof. So the channel capacity is given by C is equal to B, that is bandwidth, log of 1 plus S by N, that is signal to noise ratio, with the base 2. This is the maximum channel capacity, where C is the channel capacity, B is the bandwidth, S is the signal of power and N is the noise power. So this formula is very important as per the case of for the calculation of the channel capacity. But your received signal is the signal power S plus the noise power. So its mean square value will be under root of S plus 1. The noise power is N and its mean square value is under root N. So the number of levels can be separated without error is M is equal to under root of N plus S divided by under root of N. That is 1 plus S by N. So the digital information, you know that the information is the log of M. That is M total number of the levels, right? So that is a log of under root of 1 plus S by N to the base 2. So this square root will be of 1 by 2 log of S plus 1 plus S by N. If the channel transmitter sends the k pulses per seconds, then the channel capacity will be C is equal to I of k, that is information for the kth message, which is equal to, so this one is replaced by the k by 2 log of 1 plus S by N. But as per the Nyquist criteria, your bandwidth should be is equal to, k is equal to 2b. So your channel capacity will be b log of 1 plus S by N. But practically, if you increase the bandwidth, then noise also increases. And so the channel capacity cannot be made infinite. If your power density is N by 2, so your noise power will be N plus B, that is bandwidth, eta. Sorry, this is eta into B. So the channel capacity will become B, that is bandwidth log of 1 plus S by, you replace this N with the beta B. So N beta B, so transmit with this N beta B divided by S into S divided by, so multiply this factor with S and divide this factor with S. So N beta divided by S into S divided by eta log of 1 plus S by N beta. So we say take the common factor S by eta, which is nothing but the log of 1 plus S beta divided by S divided by N beta, N beta or B. The if you use this formula, limit x tends to 0, log of 1 plus x divided by 1 plus s is nothing but the log of e to the base 2, which is nothing but the 1.44. So your channel capacity will be S by N log of E to the base 2, which is 1.44, that is log of E, the value of log of E is the 1.44. So 1.44 S divided by E. If your bandwidth tends to the infinity, your channel capacity will be 1.44. So let us take the some examples related to the channel capacity. For the typical telephone line with the signal to noise ratio, that is SNR, is given here 30 dB, and the audio bandwidth, that is bandwidth, is given 3 kHz, the maximum data rate you have to calculate. So the given parameter is SNR 30 dB. 30 dB is nothing but the 10^3. So that is 10, if 10 dB, so 10^1 power, 20, 10^2 power, 30 dB is nothing but 10^3 power. So SNR is given as a 30 dB, so which is nothing but the 10^3 power, and the bandwidth is 3 kHz. So the maximum data rate is equal to the channel capacity, C is equal to B, that is bandwidth log of 1 plus SNR. So bandwidth is given into 3 kHz, so 3 × 10^3 log of 1 plus 10^3, so which is approximately equal to the 3 × 10^3 log of 1001 divided by log 2. So I replace this log, this A divided by log 2. So which is nothing but the 3 × 10^6 bits per second, which is 3 megabits per second. So in this way you calculate the data rate for this example. So Let us take one more example for the channel capacity calculation. The example is like this. For the satellite TV channel with the signal to noise ratio of 20 dB, a video bandwidth is of 100 MHz. Find the maximum data rate. Here the signal to noise ratio is given as a 20 dB, which is 10^2. Bandwidth is 10 MHz, which is 10 × 10^6. So the channel capacity is B log of 1 plus SNR. So bandwidth is given as a 10 × 10^6 plus 10 × 10^6 log of 1 plus 10^2, which is 10^7 log of 101 divided by log 2, which is approximately equal to 6.6 × 10^7 bits per second, which is 6.6 megabits per second. Take one more example for the channel capacity. The example is like this. A Gaussian channel has 1 MHz bandwidth. Calculate the channel capacity if the signal to noise spectral density ratio S by N is 10^5 Hz. Also find the maximum information rate. Here the bandwidth is given 1 MHz, which is 10^6 Hz, SNR 10^5, and channel capacity will be B log of 1 plus SNR. So 10^6 log of 1 plus 10^5, which is 10^6 log of 1 × 4 × 0.1 divided by log of 2. So which is approximately equal to 16.6 × 10^6 bits per second, which is equal to 16.6 megabits per second. So in this way you can calculate the channel capacity as well as the data rate for the Shannon's Hartley theorem, as per the Shannon's Hartley theorem. Thank you.